If you don't want to watch parts 1 to 4, which I fully understand, and you just want to start from a fresh start, then this is the place to be. This is the fresh start. It will accompany you. If you do want to watch parts 1 to 4, then please do, because it will supplement this video. If you just want a summary of what happened, I can put it down into 6 points. Number 1, lucid dreaming is about knowing you're dreaming, not about control. Number 2, sleep more. Number 3, change your sleep pattern slowly. Number 4, wake up the same time every morning and get up straight away. Number 5, reality checks. During the day, periodically say, where are you, how long have you been there, and where were you before? Number 6, there are different types of dream journals you can have, books and audio. Audio is better, books is my preference. 35 minutes and 6 bullet points, no wonder you didn't like the series. Now roll the video! Welcome to Learn As I Learn Lucid Dreaming Part 5. Part 5. Right, where to start? How about the 9th of January? Good as day as any.
Okay, so far, it's been day 4, and I have not remembered a single dream. When we go to sleep, now, from now on, we will, in our heads, say over and over again as we're trying to drift off to sleep, say, tonight, I will remember my dreams. Tonight, I will remember my dreams.
Now, this is called a mantra. Now, a mantra is any phrase that is repeated over and over again in your head or out loud to have a desired effect. In lucid dreaming, the mantra that we choose in this episode was, tonight I will remember more of my dreams. This embeds an idea into our brains so that when we wake up or when we're in the dream state, we will more likely remember most of our dreams. It's a very handy tip, and it does come in handy for mnemonically induced lucid dreams in the future.
So I've been keeping a diary for the past 5 days now, and this is all I have. Allow me to read you what my first dream was. The 9th to the 10th of January 2016. Details were vague, but more of my dreams were present. I know I was at laser tag, day residue in brackets.
Day residue, what did you do with the day residue?
Laser tag.
You're gonna try and take the corner? Stop me, I'll come in late.
Yeah, Reggie, we're gonna need that, yeah.
Who's first?
I'll go up the short side on the left. You go.
Yeah, we all have to go up the same way.
Yeah.
Oh, it's like dinosaurs.
The long stick. Hey, what did he go?
Go. Wait, no!
Here we go!
I got him! He's out! Join us!
Yes!
No! Yes!
No! Well done, team!
So well.
Day residue is the name of a lingering memory of something that you've done during your waking life that has transcended and seeped into your dream world and you've dreamt about it. It could be, for example, like mine, laser tag. I went to laser tag with my friends. That night, I dreamt about laser tag. Also, the night after that, I dreamt about laser tag. Let's do a different example. Let's say you've gone to hospital during the day. You've broken your leg and you have to have an x-ray and you're there. And in your dream, you could have dreamt of a hospital, or your friend has to go to hospital, or you have to have another x-ray, or your friend has to have an x-ray, or you meet a physiotherapist, or you meet someone, a doctor, or another person called the doctor. And in that dream, in your dream, from there on, some people are having a fight. So you go to ring the police, and you go to the local police box, and then you go, hang on a minute, that's not a phone, that's the TARDIS, that's the doctors, I'm dreaming. And whilst I'm on the subject, it's no surprise that everybody wants to see Hulock, a Sherlock Holmes and Doctor Who crossover episode. That would be amazing and fan service to the maximum. But then I saw this. This is a TARDIS keychain, and it got me thinking, we are going to waste, if we have it our way, Doctor Who on Sherlock Holmes. Let's say, for example, we've got Doctor Who here, and we team him up and cross him over with Ant-Man. Think about it. Keychain TARDIS. Think about it. I'll leave you with that.
I know I was at laser tag, day residue in brackets, and in a separate dream, it was all in Italian, but I speak like no Italian. Me and Kelly were trying to get to a football match with Tony in Plymouth. That was my first dream. Now, from my memory and my past experiences, I always know that dreams, as you record them, they get longer and longer and longer. So for the first 4 days or 3 days or whatever it was, I couldn't remember any of my dreams. And then this one day, I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lines of text in a book. And probably 50% of that was filler and fluff. Details were vague, but more of my dreams were present. That's 2 lines. Who says that? No one says that. I don't speak like that. Why do I write like that? This is my book. I don't know.
Details were vague, but more of my dreams were present. This is a stupid, stupid sentence to have in my own personal dream journal. It's okay if you speak in this way, but for me, I don't speak like that, so I don't know why I write like that. If you're like me and you imagine that your dream journal is going to be one of the most personal, and I mean personal, objects you will ever own in your life, because essentially your dreams are just a swill of subconscious memories and thoughts and feelings and emotions and sometimes wish fulfillment. It's not like you're going to run around town showing everyone who you've been trying to impress. You don't need to speak like you wouldn't normally speak. You're not getting it published. Jesus. So last night, I dreamt that I was in a shopping centre as a security guard. And my handwriting is really awful first thing in the morning. Absolutely horrible. But I dreamt I was a security guard for this farm. And that's the second dream in my book so far in which I've been a security guard. I've only recorded down three dreams. We're seeing a little bit of a pattern here. Yes, yes we are. When I'm teaching lucid dreaming for the first time for someone who's a newbie, I often say don't look at the patterns. I mean, it can be quite tempting and quite awesome to see the similarities in your dreams. I said similarities, weird. But let's take this for example. This is your first dream that you have, and this is your second dream that you have in your dream journal. There's not much of a pattern. Even if we add the third, fourth, and even the fifth dream, I mean, you can make a pattern if you really tried, but it's only when you have a lot of dreams all together that you can sit back and go, oh, that's a bear. Think I made my point. Day 13, I believe. I've slept 13 times since I started this rebirth of Learn As I Learn. And in my dream journal, okay, so to give you an example of how many dreams you can expect to write down, I have nine dreams, and some of them are quite detailed, like I predicted, stretching over a page and a half, maybe, of dreams. You can see where the different colours are. Thank you, phone. See where the different colours are for different dreams. But some of them are... Look at this. I have no idea. Right, I'll read you this. 15th to the 16th of January 2016. There was a live internet event that was being hosted live by me. Couldn't remember any more than that. But that's the beauty. If you don't remember your dreams, or you don't remember much about your dreams rather, then just write down whatever you remember. It doesn't have to be detailed. I do have one really funny part in this. This is right at the end of the dream. After that, my point of view switched to a man who was on Skype with someone I knew from school, I won't name names. She was trying to demonstrate a backflip. She landed on her face, twice. That's the end of the dream. Twice. Full stop. It's cool, because once you've written down your dreams, I was going through this, even though it's only been 13 days since I started, I've forgotten some of my dreams. So going back and reading through the dreams, I was like, oh my god, yeah, I remember this dream. This is awesome. But not only that, but you can picture it in your head where your dream is, and this is what you want. So from here on, I think I'm going to read through my dreams before I go to sleep, or before I try to go to sleep anyway. Also, I've had an issue with sleeping, and I think I've got a solution. It is a fact that looking at a backlit screen stops you from going to sleep more effectively. From here on in our lucid dreaming practices, we are not going to bring any tablets, any mobile phones, any laptops. We're not going to sit at the screen for a long time. What we're going to do, reading through your dream journal as you're falling to sleep or trying to go to sleep, probably will help. So, reading through our dream journal as we're going to sleep will help us not only fall asleep quicker because we're not staring at a backlit screen, which reacts with photosensitive cells in the back of our eyes, which secrete a hormone responsible for waking people up because it represents daytime. Light is daytime, so our body clock will wake ourselves up. But not only will that help go to sleep better, but it will also help us pin down what we want to do in our dream, so we're not spending too much time focusing about. And on top of that, our dream recall increased because the dreams that we're reading, we're also thinking about in our head and picturing where we were at that time. So it will help with our dream recall. So reading through a dream journal helps in three different ways. So it didn't help last night, not even a little bit. It didn't help because I didn't even try. Went to bed, started flicking through my dreams, and I thought, ah, do you know what, I'm not actually feeling too good. So I put the book down, and then my partner wasn't feeling too good either. So after a long time, we decided to not bother going to sleep and just go in the front room and, you know, watch a bit of TV. So I ended up eating a cottage pie at like 2 o'clock in the morning, watched Age of Ultron.
I also watched 2 episodes of Teen Wolf and an episode of Daredevil. So good night, actually. Good night.
So thanks, everyone. That's it for this video of Learn As I Learn Part 5. Thank you for waiting so patiently. It's only been, 8 months? Next time you see Learn As I Learn will be Part 6 on the 2nd of March, which is a Tuesday. And next week's video is going to be about Mutual Dreams, which is on the 9th. Stay tuned for that. Thank you very much.